Larry Nichols is our guest. Mr. Nichols is a man that I've grown to respect. He was a former member of the Bill and Hillary Clinton kitchen cabinet, if you will. He has a very rich history with respect to time with the Clintons. Mr. Nichols really knows where the bodies are buried. He's had a change of heart, of faith, of he's a changed man, and he's now wants to tell the story of the Clintons. But more importantly, he wants to explain to everyone why it's important today and what we need to do to fight this machinery that is bearing down upon us. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Nichols is somewhat a little bit, you know, not feeling too well right now. So I want you to keep him in your prayers. And anyone who comes forward with information like Mr. Nichols has, I would really like you to keep him in your prayers. Larry Nichols, welcome to the Hagman and Hagman Report. Thank you so much for joining us tonight.
Hey, well, thank you. And thank you for the introduction, gosh. I wish I thought as much of me as you just said. I guess the best thing I can say to people is when the question is asked, who's Larry Nichols? I was with the Clintons when they were first introduced to Arkansas running for governor. He was already attorney general. The people that hired me, Mr. Rich Stevens and his brother Jack, they wanted him to become the boy governor. And so that's when I came on the case. And folks, I met him. He was, without a doubt, he was a challenge. Now guys, I gotta tell you, I was probably, oh wow, this would have been mid-70s, so I would have been in my mid to late 20s when I met him. He was pushing 30. He wasn't quite yet 30. The young fool that I was, it was a challenge. So folks, I'm saying this to you, boring you with this little bit of an intro relative to the background so that you understand. I live this day because of a mistake I made back then. I am living proof to anyone that be careful what you do today, because it may come back and haunt you later in life. So be careful what you do. When I met Bill Clinton, I realized the first night that we had a fundraiser for he and Hillary to introduce him to the farmers from Northeast Arkansas, the wealthy farmers. This probably says it all about Bill and Hillary. We had the fundraiser scheduled for that night at 8 o'clock. Bill got there about 7:30. Literally from the moment he got to the restaurant, y'all, I would turn around, he would be gone. And waitresses would come up to me and say, would you please get him off of us? Because he was running around pinching them in the butt, or he was talking dirty to them or something. I mean, this was mid-70s, deep south. So I did everything I could to keep him chained in or corralled in a little bit. 8 o'clock got there. No Hillary. Remember, we were holding up people eating. And the people came from Northeast Arkansas, so they had a pretty good drive if they weren't staying the night to get back home. 8 o'clock came, no Hillary, so nobody could eat. 8:30 came, no Hillary, so people couldn't eat. And it was a buffet thing, and management at the restaurant was saying, hey, you know, you need to get along through this line. So we started the line. So finally, about 8:45, Hughes came. Hillary came. I turned to find Bill, couldn't find him. He was gone. So I was forced to approach Hillary by myself. I had not met her yet. When I went up, I immediately noticed the first Hillary Rodham that I ever met. Her hair was filthy. When you got within 10 feet of her, you could smell her. She had hairy legs, hair under her arms. She was wearing a muumuu, that was just like a sack dress. And she had on flip-flops. And this was a semi-formal meet and greet for the prospective first lady of Arkansas. Now, wow. That's bad enough, what I've just told you, but as I got closer, I noticed around her neck the thing that still haunts me today, and I see it just like I did that day. She had a chain like the chain dog tags have. It wasn't dog tags. It was it looked to me like what you see today. Reporters have a press pass. you know, and it's attached to some chain. Well, this looked like that. But I couldn't read it. As I got closer, I could read it. When I got up to her, but that card around her neck on that chain said she was a proud member of the United States Communist Party.
There. Wow.
Yeah. Wow. I didn't really say wow. I turned to her and I said, Miss Clinton, I'm not Clinton. And I said, Miss Clinton, she said, I'm not Miss Clinton. You can call me Miss Rodham. She's married to Bill, but it was a hippie thing, and she wasn't going to take his name. I tried to mention that card around her neck, and to my shock, she yelled out, Bill, get this SOB. She didn't say SOB. Out of my blanking face. She was the first woman I ever heard use the F word, literally. And she screamed it out loud. This is Deep South, guys, in the mid-70s.
In the mid-70s. Okay.
Mid-70s. I wanted to crawl under a table. Well, I turned. I couldn't find Bill. I asked one of the people there. I was in such a state of shock. And this woman came up to me and said, Mr. Evans, you've got to get to him. He's in the woman's restroom with the waitress. You know, I'm just going, oh, God. I tried to send somebody to go get him. About that time, she hollered it out the second time, louder. Now, guys, when she hollered it that second time, I kid you not, you could hear a pin drop. And everybody was just aghast. I mean, everybody was just trying to breathe. I mean, it was horrible. Still no Bill. She hollered it a third time, and it was just so loud. And I promise you, folks, I promise you, you could have heard a feather fall. Well, Bill comes around the corner. I'm ready to call it off. I'm ready to call it quick. The best we could do was get a man I had not yet met. His name was Webb Hubbell. Best we could do was get Hubbell to get her out of the building. She left. We introduced Bill, and he talked to the people. And that night, I noticed one thing. The one thing I noticed that night, Bill had this ability to win these dang people over. In spite of what had just occurred. Oh, he had them laughing and giggling. The night ended. Now, y'all, that was the first meeting I had with Hillary Robinson. But he was going to be the youngest governor in our history if we could pull it off. And I want everybody in this audience to see as best you can that visual. That's why I hope I painted as good a picture with words as I can. And I was told that night by Bill, that she hated bathing.
She hated
taking baths.
Oh. Wow.
I mean, because I thought she had been doing something and just had failed to take a bath and just got there in the nick of time. And please don't let her come like that anymore. So she don't like to take baths. And she didn't think it was necessary for her to have to shave her legs and her underarms. Men didn't. Now, that's the first visual I want y'all to remember of Hillary Rodham, who became Hillary Rodham Clinton. The next thing I want y'all to visualize, most of y'all saw it or have seen it, and that is Hillary in the Benghazi hearing when, basically, I'm paraphrasing, she said about four people that had died, what difference does it make they're dead?
Yes.
The way she said that, the coldness to which she said that is Hillary. That, Doug, is the Hillary I knew every day during the 10 so years that I was with him. Every day, that was the Hillary. She was the coldest woman. She was probably the coldest individual I had ever been around. She did not believe in the art of, you know, just getting along. She didn't.
With all due respect, people have accused us of, you know, misleading Americans. I can say I would recommend highly, it is our job to do everything we can to kill some Americans. They attacked, they killed our people. There are questions being raised. Now, was information developing, understanding what was going on? Would we reach conclusions later that weren't reached initially? Because even today, what difference at this point does it make? The fact is, it is our job to kill some Americans. With all due respect,